Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, help me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn.
Today has been one of those days where we got a little bit of everything as far as weather. Started off rainy, real hard. The wind started blowing. But as I sat here at my desk and I looked out the window, I was amazed still at the beauty. And then as the day went on, it all dried up. The clouds started parting and some sunshine started coming through. And then by the evening, it was the most beautiful, beautiful sunset. And I took so many pictures and I posted them on Facebook. But as I reflected over what the weather was and how it changed in a day, it also reminded me of this beautiful person that I've blogged on so much, that I've shared so much about, and I've never even met her in person, Joey Feek. As I have read so many blogs, so many tributes that people have put out there, and I've seen pictures of her just smiling, pictures of her playing her guitar, pictures with her adorable dog that she so dearly loves. And one of the pictures that I absolutely adore and reading Rory's blog was when they were potty training Indi, and they pulled over to the side of the road, and Joey got out with an umbrella and covered up little Indi while she sat on her potty chair. And she was teaching her how to go potty. But the love that Joey and Rory have for each other is amazing. She's such an incredible, beautiful soul. And even though this ugly thing that's called cancer became a part of her life, there are so many pictures of her still smiling. Precious Lord, take my hand. Amazing pictures of love that still radiates from her face. And I'm amazed, just literally amazed, that here it is, March the 2nd. She wasn't sure she was going to make it through certain landmarks that had already been posted for the future, and a lot of them for February. And she's still with us. I love the pictures of Joey and Rory holding hands, sitting together side by side in the chair, smiling. So many cute little hats that she wears as she sits in bed, and she's just smiling real big. And she's an amazing, beautiful woman. Someone that I truly admire. Someone that has left a forever love in my heart. And when I think of love, I think of 2 Corinthians. In the passage, or excuse me, 1 Corinthians 13, 4 and 7, it says, love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. always perseveres. And everything that I've read of Joey, everything that I've seen of Joey has been amazing. And this is what it speaks of, is this kind of love. I look at the pictures and I see the love that Joey has for her husband. But I see this love that Rory has for Joey, because he's on the opposite side. He's still very healthy, strong. And I see the little things that he has done for Joey. And it amazes me. And I think one of the special ones is Valentine's Day. And I see little things that stood out to me as I zoom into the picture. I guess the sweetness of, he has a little boutonniere on and she has a corsage, a wrist corsage. Now that to me is just priceless. I love it. I love that there are little Valentines in a bowl, the little sweet cups with hearts on them. You can see so much love that went into this preparation. He talks about how she loves sushi, how he went and got the things that she loved, and the flowers. That's love. And then as you see him laying next to her, as she's so weak, yet incredibly beautiful. She has never lost her beauty. And he holds her in his arms. The cake. The little heart cake that says Happy Valentine's Day. How she has her hands together in amazement. It's a true, beautiful love. And in the past, when I've done these, I have struggled, really struggled, without crying. You know, because it's so emotional, the hurt, the pain. But she has hung on so very long. And her flame is getting dimmer in the sense of breath. But on the other hand, her flame is brighter, stronger, bigger than it's ever been. I see the pictures of Indiana's birthday. And now Joey's sitting in the bed, and she's clapping with her beautiful little baby girl. And you zoom in and you look at her face, and it's just still pure radiance. I love this little saying that says, I like you a lot-al. It's like a little, except a lot. I really feel that way about Joey. I feel that way about Rory. They are just incredible, incredible people. And I know that grief is truly the last act of love we have to give to those that we love. And where there is deep grief, there was great love. Sometimes someone comes into your life that changes things forever, raises the standards, makes you laugh. It makes you feel like you, there's something about that person that you can't put into words. And even though you may not know them or be with them, you just don't want to let them go, because they've been so incredible here on this earth. And I just wanted to do one last tribute to my beautiful friend, Joey. And as I read in Rory's blog, as he expressed his words, Joey gathered their family together around her, and she said goodbye to each of them, to her mother and father and her three sisters. There were lots of tears as she explained to each one how much she loved them and that she was going to be going home soon. That her time here was done and she was going to go to sleep soon. And then she asked me to bring our baby in. And so I set our little Indi on Joey's lap and we all cried with my wife as she told her how much her mama loved her. And you be a big girl for your papa. And that mama will be watching over you. And then she pulled Indiana up and she kissed her. One last kiss. I think of the word true and love. And true stands for trust, romance, understanding, excitement, love, listening, overcoming, valuable, and everything. When I think of Joey and Rory's love story, that's what I think about. I can just picture Rory saying, "And then my soul saw you." And it kind of went, "Oh, there you are. I've been looking for you." And you know, as Joey expressed, he has no regrets. And as he so beautifully said, God only gives each of us a certain amount of time to be on this earth, and every day when we wake up, we get to decide how we are going to spend those precious minutes and hours. There are no do-overs, no second chances, no next time around to get it right. Joey knew this, and she has made each and every day count. One of the last things Joey said before she drifted into a deep sleep she's been in for a few days now is, "I have no regrets. I can honestly say that I have done everything I wanted to do and live the life I always wanted to live." Wow. Wow. As I said, her flame burns brighter. As Rory said, "My wife has been asleep for days now, and her body is shutting down quickly. The hospice nurse came again this morning and said Joey was most likely only be with us for a few more days, at the most. Joey, as your wonderful husband Rory sits by your side, the room is quiet and there's no movement from your body, and he holds your hand. His love for you is still so strong and beautiful. As your loved ones come in and hug you and say their goodbyes, and as you kiss your beautiful baby goodbye, just know that you will never, ever be forgotten. I can see you now, sitting in your rocking chair, up there on those beautiful puffy clouds, just rocking with that beautiful smile of yours, looking down and saying, "Don't worry about anything. Instead, Just pray about everything. Tell God your needs. And don't forget to thank Him for His answers. And if you do this, you will experience God's peace, which is far more wonderful than the human mind can understand. His peace will keep your thoughts and your hearts quiet and at rest as you trust in Christ Jesus. So for now, goodbye, my friend.
Help me stand, for I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light, and take my hand, precious Lord.